Hello and welcome to another Java and Android Studio tutorial. My name is Cal and in today's tutorial we're going to be looking at time pickers. We're going to be building a simple pop-up time picker. I'll show you how you can use either the analog clock style time picker, which is the default, or you can turn your time picker into more of a spinner style. So it's pretty basic, it's a pretty quick video today. If you're interested, I also did a video quite similar to this on date pickers, so I'll leave a link in the description to that video if you want to tie together date pickers with time pickers. Creating a new Android Studio project, empty activity, giving it incorrectly a name of timer picker tutorial. It's actually a time picker tutorial. I don't know why I put an R there, but anyway, our programming language is Java and I'm just going to hit finish. The first thing we're going to do is head into res and values and add in some colors to our colors.xml file. I'm going to create a color calling it dark gray, and then another color, I'm calling this one light gray. Heading into themes, I'm just going to apply those colors. So our primary color is going to be our dark gray color and our variant is going to be black. We're going to head into our activity main XML file. I'm going to change this text view to a button. I'm going to apply the view's background color to this light gray color that we just created. And then I'm just going to drag that up a little bit so we get this constraint vertical bias, and I'm going to set that to 0.1. I'm going to change the text to select time, text size 30sp, give it a width of maybe not 500dp, but 300 dp looks pretty good, and a height of 100 dp, removing the horizontal bias constraint, and then we're going to create an ID, we're just calling it time button, as well as an on-click listener, calling it pop time picker. And if we click on that little alert, it gives us an option to create our pop time picker function in our main activity, so we're just going to hit OK on that. Now we can create a button at the top, I'm just calling it time button, and we're just going to find that by its ID, so I think we called it time button, yeah we did. So find view by ID, time button. Next, we're going to declare an hour and minute variable. These are ints, and these are going to store the selected hour and the selected minute. And then inside our pop time picker function, we're just going to say time picker dialog.onTimeSetListener. Just naming it onTimeSetListener is equal to new time picker dialog.onTimeSetListener. And it's going to give us this override method of onTimeSet. And if we just change those in, so the first one is actually selected hour and the next one is selected minute, we can then just apply that to our hour and minute variables. We're going to say time button.setText string format, giving it our default locale. Our format is going to be to two decimal places with a semicolon in the middle, and just passing in our hour and minute variables. Below that, we're just going to declare a time picker dialog. We've called it time picker dialog is equal to new time picker dialog. I'm going to give it a context of this. I'm going to give it our on time set listener as well as hour minute. And then the final variable we can pass through is 24 hour view. I've selected true, but obviously if you pass through false, you're just going to get 12 hour time. Time picker dialog.set title, I'm just going to call it select time. And finally, we just want to say time picker dialog.show. Cool. And if we build and run this now, you can see we've got a working pop-up time picker. You can select the time and it'll put it back into the button's text. Currently, this time picker is just using the default time picker style, which is this analog clock selector. However, if we want to turn our time picker into a more of a spinner style, all we have to do is apply a style that is a spinner. So I'm just going to declare an int, I'm calling it style, and it's equal to alert dialog theme hello dark. There's a lot of styles, this is just one of the styles that I like the look of, and we just need to pass that into our time picker dialog after we pass in the context. Cool, and if we build and run this again, you can see that the time picker is behaving exactly the same, except the view is now a spinner instead of that analog clock. I hope you enjoyed this Android Studio time picker tutorial, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.